It's not uncommon to get fruit off of ornamentals during this time of year, but this year has been a most unusual time because we're getting so many requests and calls, and people are really anxious to find out if things are edible, and we want to go over some of those fruits that are showing up on ornamentals through the months of October and November. The first one we want to talk to you about is the Osage orange, or the bodark, and another common name is the hedge or horse apple. And you're probably familiar with these green, knotty type growths that you'll see most often in the pastures or along roadsides. But again, this is a native tree. It's got a short trunk. It's really known for its rounded growth pattern, and that you'll see a lot of spines and again these big hard fruit. And the height of these are going to be anywhere from 20 to 40 feet, and they're a relatively fast growing tree, and they're also dioecious, which means they're male and female trees. Now the flowers are really inconspicuous, so you really won't notice them that much. And also you'll see a few pest problems out in the native plants, maybe some leaf spots and scale, but really nothing to be concerned about. But obviously the native plant is really not that great of a selection for a landscape plant. However, there's many new cultivars that are being released from Kansas State and other universities that I think in a couple of years you're really going to be excited about. They're going to have thick leaves, they're going to be fast growing, they're spineless, they're fruitless. Again, I think it's going to be a great tree for some of our Oklahoma conditions, so we'll keep you informed on those as time comes around. Now you'll see the fruit here, again as it's cut open, is kind of sugary and it does have a sweet smell to it. They're quite hard, and we see a little bit of research reports that from time to time saying that they're good for insect control, but I think really the best way to control insects are just to throw them or squish them with them. But again, we're not recommending that you eat these because there's some reports where people have gotten sick, and again, they're really not that palatable. Now the next one we want to talk about is the trifoliate orange, and you'll see the fruit here. We've cut one open. Again, it's a citrus smell. It's very seedy. Again, they're kind of hard. And this particular one you see most often as a shrub and sometimes as a novelty plant, where people allow them to grow their full height, and you'll see the decorative fruit on them this time of year. But the best way that the hardy citrus or the hardy rootstock or the trifoliate orange is used is as a rootstock for the citrus that is grown in Florida and Texas and California. What they're doing, they're grafting the citrus onto this rootstock of the trifoliate orange, and that is because it withstands the tough conditions, it's more cold tolerant, and it passes a little bit of that cold tolerance on to the citrus. So that's how it's used most often. Now it also has thorns. It gets the name trifoliate from the three leaflets that you'll see, and it's considered deciduous. You'll lose some of those leaves during the winter time, just like you would with the bodark as well. Now it's most often used as a hedge, which you see here at Oklahoma State University campus, but it can get anywhere from 8 to 20 feet in height, and it's a slow to medium growth. Right. Now, occasionally you'll find some fragrant flowers, but again, they're not that showy, and they bloom usually in April and May. And then this time of year, some of the plants will be loaded with the fruit, which again is very sour, hard, and there's very little flesh. So again, it's one that's really not that palatable, and there's really not a lot of recommendations on trying to eat it. And it's very few pest problems, so it has its place in a landscape as well. Now the last one we want to talk to you about is the common flowering quince, and you'll see those here, and they kind of resemble pears or apples, and they are in the same family, which is the rose family. And this shrub, which is behind me here, we've got two or three varieties on our landscape grounds here at Oklahoma Gardening, and you'll see one here which is Texas Scarlet, and we've got some fruit here. We also have a variety Cameo. Now this shrub is also deciduous, and one of the characteristics are some of the leaf whorls that are around the foliage. Now they're going to get anywhere between 4 and 10 feet in height, and the flowers range from anywhere from white to a reddish pink color and even an orange color, and they bloom early in the spring, and really in some cases they'll take the place of azaleas because they don't need the acidic soil, so they're a good early spring blooming plant. Now you'll see a few blooms that we're showing you from some plants this time of year where the short days have confused them, but it's not very heavy in bloom, but you'll see a few this time of year too. And again, the only pest problem that we've been faced with is some of the leaf spots where they'll defoliate in the spring where there's an awful lot of moisture or rainfall that we'll get. Now, these fruits are considered edible, and we want to go into the kitchen and see what kind of ideas Barb has for us.
We hope you enjoyed this video. It's part of our OK Gardening Classics YouTube channel. You can also find more recent videos on our Oklahoma Gardening YouTube channel. And join us on social media for great gardening tips, photos, and discussion.